After a couple of years, me and Emma, we've been toying with the idea of starting up a charity, and we finally decided to do it last summer, and we finally got it registered and we came up with the name Kids of Bolton. Bolton's our home now, and we've settled in the area, got children of our own, and I think one of the main reasons why we decided to do this is, you know, we're constantly getting letters into the club asking for help to support and kids in and around this area and throughout the country who are in difficult positions and have difficult upbringings, and at the same time saying that there's a lot of talented kids out there as well, and sometimes for whatever reason they can't fulfil their potential. So we want to try and help them best we can, and you know, we're delighted the way the charity's going so far. I think looking back on my sort of upbringing, I'm one of six growing up on a council estate in Sheffield. I know it was difficult at times for my parents to provide for me and my interest in football, as well as all my other interests in my brothers and sisters, so it was difficult for them. I know at times my first manager had to step in and provide sort of boots and kit for me. So I think that's one of the reasons why we're doing this now. Obviously I've worked extremely hard and been fortunate enough to play football for a long time and earn a good living and be able to provide for my own children.
I grew up really from the age of zero, where you've seen where I was born, until I left here and I was about 11. So it's nice to come back and see where I was growing up and all the mischief used to happen, really. So I got my pace from. I used to come down with my older brother. He was a junior blade. It's where I first had my sort of heartbroken as a 15-year-old. I was here from sort of 11 years old at the academy and got told at 15 that I wasn't wanted, really. So it's being a fan, and it was difficult to take at the time, and just looking back on it now, I think it's probably the best thing that ever happened to me, really. But it's still a club that's close to my heart, really. I have to look out for their results. Nice to be back and just to come down here every home game with my brother. It's brilliant. Into the community and visit some of these organisations and schools and individuals. I think we're really pleased with the decision to set this charity up. We've met some great individuals and some organisations, you know, like Bolton Metro Swimming Club. We've been into schools, Johnson's Fold recently. You know, they're funding a little boxing and wrestling club. But it's difficult for the school to keep funding that sort of an after-school activity, and we're really impressed with the children down there, so we're going to try and help fund them and keep that going for the kids, because they really enjoy it, and we feel that's important for them to keep in sport.
It's amazing to see what Kevin's doing. You know, I'm a big fan of Kevin Davies, and you know, plays for one of the best football teams in Britain, but for what he's doing for these youngsters, the kids of Bolton, it is a massive thing. Keeping the kids off the street, getting them involved in something like football or whatever it is, it's gonna give them discipline and put them on the right path.
Been into a school called St Catherine's, who were trying to start a new scheme called Lads and Dads, and it's just helping, encouraging the dads to get involved with the school and interacting with their children.
Kids of Bolton have been really kind enough to get involved in supporting a project to get children and the dads together to be involved in health and fitness with a little bit of fortune coaching skills along the way.
We've got Kevin as a great role model. He's worked alongside the dad doing football skills, and we're going to get the children doing some health and fitness, healthy eating and that sort of thing. Doing a bit of literacy, but a lot of fun.